Good morning all of you. Today we are going to discuss about the flower. Okay, flowers are the most colorful and attractive part of the plants, isn't it? It's many colors of flowers you may have seen. Okay, the pink color flowers are there, blue color flowers are there, red colors are there, right? It is very attractive part of the plant. And what is the function of the flower in a plant? Okay, let's see. Flowers are making the fruits and the seeds. Okay, from the seeds the new plant is arising. Okay, from where we are getting the new plant? Almost all time we are getting the new plant from the seeds. And if we are getting a new organism from a parent organism, what we are calling that process in biology? We are calling it as reproduction. We got a new organism here. New plant we got from the seed. And this process that we are calling it as what? Reproduction. And now we can define flowers as the part of the reproduction. Otherwise, flowers are the reproductive part of a plant. Okay, what are flowers? They are the reproductive part of the plant. Let us see what are the parts of a flower. Okay, in a basic flower, it has got four parts. Four parts are there. And the first part is calyx. What is calyx? And second one is corolla. Third is andrecium. And fourth is gynecium. Okay. These are the four major parts of the flower. Okay. First one is calyx. Second is corolla. Third is andrecium. And fourth is gynecium. Let us see what is calyx. Calyx is the outermost bud of the flower. Okay. This is the outermost bud of the flower. You may have seen that a flower has got cup-like portion at the bottom of the flower, isn't it? It may be green in color. Most probably it will be green in color. This portion. And this portion that we are calling it as what? We are calling it as calyx. This cup-like portion at the bottom of the flower, we are calling it as what? Calyx. And you can see that the calyx is made with this kind of single leaf-like structure. Okay? Single leaf-like structures are there. And this is known as sepal. Means so many sepals are joining together to form the entire calyx. Okay, the single unit of calyx is sepal. So many sepals are grouping together to form the calyx. Okay, this is the calyx. This is the outermost bud of the flower. Inner to that, we can see a colorful part of the flower. Okay, this is a colorful part of the flower. And it is centered also. What do you mean by centered? It has got some fragrance. Okay. Smell you are getting from the flower, right? And this is the centered part of the flower and it is colored, okay? And the entire portion of this part, the colorful portion, that we are calling as corolla. That is the second bud, the second layer or the second bud of the flower, that is corolla. And it is made with single petals, okay? Here, sepals are forming calyx like that. The petals are forming corolla. Single units of corolla is known as petals. Understood? So the second bud of the flower is corolla. And what about the third bud? Third bud is known as andrecium. What it is? Andrecium. Andrecium means this is the main reproductive part of the flower. Okay? Andrecium means what? This is the main reproductive part of the flower. And andrecium is made with so many stamens. Okay? Single units of stamen will be like this. Like so many stamens are grouping together to form the andrecium. You can see here. See, a single unit. This is one stamen. This is another one. This is another one. This is another one. Like that, it is making a round inside. Okay? The entire round, we are calling it as what? Andrecium. And the single unit, the single one is called as what? Stamen. And what is the part of the stamen? Stamen has got, majorly it has got two parts. What are they? This part is known as the filament. Okay? This part of stamen is known as what? Filament. And bulged portion is here. Isn't it? And this is known as the anther. Okay? So this is the filament and this is the anther. Inside anther, a fine dust-like particles are there. What we are calling it as? We are calling it as pollen grains. Okay? What is that? Pollen grains. You may have experienced that when you are touching a flower, some dust-like particles may be there in your finger. Isn't it? Dust-like particles. And that is what? Pollen grains. That is coming out from the anther. Okay? And from this pollen grains, the male gametes are formed. Okay. So andrecia is the third gall of the flower. Okay. This is the male reproductive part. Okay. And it is made with what? Stamens. Okay. So many stamens are grouping together to form the entire gall. That is andrecia. What is the structure of a single stamen? It has what? Two parts. What are they? This is filament and this is anther. Okay. Inside the anther, pollen grains are there, and from the pollen grains, the male gametes are forming. Understood? And the fourth gall or the innermost gall of the flower, that is gynoecium. What is that? Gynoecium. Okay. Gynoecium is the female reproductive part of the flower. Okay. Female reproductive part of the flower is gynoecium. And it is made with carpels, otherwise we can call it as pistils. Okay. So what is the structure of a pistil? See, inside this flower itself, you can see this is a single pistil. Okay. This is a single pistil. Okay. I have drawn this picture is a single pistil. See, it has got three major parts. What are they? This part of the pistil is known as stigma. Okay. Stigma. This distant portion of the carpel is known as stigma. This tube-like portion is known as style. Okay, style. And the bulb-like portion is known as ovary. Okay, so these are the three parts of a pistil. What are they? Stigma, style, and ovary. Okay, and you can see inside the ovary some dots I have put here, right? And these are the ovules. Okay. These are the ovules. From the ovules, the eggs are forming or the female gametes are forming. We have seen that from the pollen grain, the male gametes are forming. And here, from the ovules, the eggs or the female gametes are forming. Understood? So these are the four gals of the flowers. Calyx, corolla, andrecium and gynoecium. Okay. And another part that you can see here, I have marked it as stalk. Okay. And when we studied the leaf also, there was a cylindrical portion, a small portion which is connecting the leaf to the stem. We call it as a stalk of the leaf. Like that. Here also cylindrical portion is here. Okay. Which is connecting the flower to the stem. Okay. The flower will be on a stem. So there will be a portion which is connecting the flower and the stem together. So that portion is known as stalk, and the stalk is also known as pedicel. Okay. And some flowers has got there not be the stalk. Okay. Some flowers will be there where stalk is not there. That kind of flowers that we are calling it as sessile flowers. Okay. So what are sessile flowers? Flowers which doesn't have stalk is known as sessile flowers. And look at the stalk, you can see that here a distant portion is there. Okay, the distant portion of the stalk that we are calling as calamus. From here, the other part of the flowers are starting. Okay, so these are the entire parts of a flower. Okay, so we can summarize the class. Flowers are the reproductive part of the plants. Okay, and what are the basic parts of the flowers? Four parts are there: calyx, corolla, andrecium and gynoecium. Calyx is the outermost part made with sepals. And colored part of the flower, that is the second word, that is not as what? Corolla, made with petals. And the third part or the third ball of the flower, that is andrecium, which is the male reproductive part of the flower, which are made with stamens. Okay, stamen has got filament and anther. Inside the anther, pollen grains are there. Innermost gall is known as the gynoecium, that is a female reproductive part of the flower, which are made with pistils. Okay, and what are the three parts of the pistils? Stigma, style, and ovary. Inside the ovary, ovules are there. Okay, these are arising the female gametes. So that's all about the structure of the flower. And in next class, we are going to discuss about the types of flowers. Thank you.